here, and we're at the Martino State Fish and Wildlife Area. It's February 16th. It's about 2 in the afternoon. The air temperature is around 20 degrees, but there's a stiff wind blowing, and it really feels cold. Today, I'm using my Grenicure DC60. I've got about 22 pounds, and then I also decided I'd go ahead and wear a fanny pack so I can put the camera in there and carry it in there for, it's just easier to access. Okay, well, let's go ahead and see if we can do about 5 or 6 miles today, and before it gets dark. Okay, see you later. Okay, well, I had to put the balaclava on. The wind is just howling out here. I've got a piece of terry cloth over the mic on the camera, so I hope that will dampen the wind and act as a muff. I'm not sure if it will or not, but I hope so. Anyway, it's a nice day, really. It's just the wind is howling, but everything else is, it's nice. It's not that cold. Today, I'm trying out some new gear. I got a GoLite Merino Wool t-shirt. That's my base layer today. And then on top of that, I've got my polyester and wool long john top. And then on top of that, I've got a 200 weight fleece half zip. And I've got my Montbel Microlite down jacket. It's a 12 ounce down jacket. I haven't had a chance to use it outside yet. And then I've got my rain shell on top of that. So we'll see how that works. So far, so good. It's been about half an hour, and the rain shell blocks the wind, and then the down underneath there, that really keeps me warm. This is a really nice looking area. I believe I'm actually on a horse trail here. There seems to be a lot of horse trails. Okay, we'll do a little 360 here. I don't know if you can see behind me. This place is located just west of Princeton, Illinois, maybe 15 miles, and then about 6 miles south of Interstate 80. Okay. All right. Well, like I said, I hope the terry cloth acts as an appropriate muff so I can get some good sound. All right, this is Jim. Signing off for now. Oh, even though the wind is blowing and it's cold out here, I'm sweating. I gotta vent a little bit. I'm gonna stop and take a little break and kind of vent a little bit. I don't want to get sweaty in this cold weather. So, but I took what I thought was going to be a trail that would lead me up a ridge down at the north end of this western edge of the property, and I ran out of trail. Also, the sun has thawed out the top, oh, say, eighth of an inch of the mud, and so it's like walking on wet clay. Every time you take a step, you're sliding in mud. There are some trails that were cut by tractor, and basically they just mowed the grass down, and it looks like they tilled one furrow along the edge of the property. So, but I'm gonna have to go backtrack now and go hopefully I can find a way that's gonna take me east and north. That way is north, and kind of behind me is east. So we'll see. It's when you're mucking along, boy, it's kind of hard going in that muck. You're sliding and you're slopping your shoes and you're sucking in the mud a little bit. No fun, but we'll get where we want to go eventually. Okay. Not sure exactly what time it is. Oh, here's another piece. Finally getting to use my wrist warmers. They're a double layer. They have a polyester nylon sleeve, and then on top of that is a merino wool sleeve. And as long as I'm moving, just my fleece liners will be fine. They seem to be doing just fine. Okay, well, I'm going to backtrack. There we go. Now we're starting to bend a little bit. And then we'll pick it up. Hopefully I can get to the other side of the... There's a body of water back there, about 700 yards. And I'm going to have to get around the south end of that. So hopefully I can. I might have to drive around to the other parking area. I'm not sure. Okay, this is Jim. Signing off. Well, I did a little bushwhacking back there. The trail kind of follows that ridge and goes off to the left, and then went up and down a couple of small ridges back there. Whew, tough going up and down those hills. Had to use to get down on all fours and climb up. It was so steep. All right, over there is a looks like a tree stand. So, guess someone's hunting. I'll go take a picture.